Welcome back, students. We have completed the topic suppression techniques. We divided this topic into three subheadings. We studied how we are going to separate two or more solids, then mixture of solid and liquid, and lastly mixture of liquids. Today we are going to study separation of mixture by using more than one method. Look, a mixture which has only two components or constituent can be separated by a single method, but a mixture which has more than two component can be separated into individual component by a combination of method of separation. These methods are applied turn by turn. Okay, the separation of mixture by using a combination of method will become clear with this example which I am going to share with you. Now you can see sample problem 1. Now look how you will separate iron fillings, ammonium chloride and sand from their mixture. Keep in mind, the component will decide what separation technique we have to use. We are having iron fillings, this ammonium chloride and sand. Look, iron fillings are attracted by a magnet. So a magnet can be used to remove iron filling first. When iron filling will be removed, then ammonium chloride and sand are remaining. We know that ammonium chloride is known for sublimation. It can undergo sublimation, that's why we will heat it, and by sublimation we will separate ammonium chloride and sand will left behind. In this manner, by using two techniques, we separated these three things. Now I am giving you one more situation. Think that you are having this ammonium chloride, okay, first thing, then you are having sand, and third one you are having is common salt. Now we have to separate these three things. Look, firstly we will do sublimation and we will remove ammonium chloride. When ammonium chloride will be removed, the thing which will left will be sand and salt. Then we will add water to this mixture and salt will get dissolved to water. Okay, by decantation you can remove it. So sand will be separated. We can even use filtration. Keep in mind. Now you are having salt solution. It means a mixture of salt and water. To get back salt, you can do evaporation. So sometimes even four methods can be used to separate just three components, as we discussed now. Let's move to the next topic. We will understand the supply of drinking water in a city. Look, students, in any city, the water can be collected from any river, lake, pond, okay? So there will be a reservoir here from which water will be collected to sedimentation tank. In sedimentation tank, the impurities present in water which are heavier than water, they get settled. They settle down and the water move to the next loading tank. In loading tank, the impurities are further settled by using alum, okay, also known as Pitcairn. So after loading tank, the water goes to filtration tank where there is a layer of gravel, fine sand, and the water passes over it. All the organic impurities like algae, these kind of thing are separated here. Then this water is shifted to a chlorination tank and chlorine is added here to kill the bacteria and other things present in water. Then this goes to your home. So this is the entire process for supply of drinking water, or you can say purification of water. We are going to understand physical and chemical changes. Now before that, you must have observed that when you left milk without boiling, okay, in summer, it converts to curd. You must have seen that on cutting paper you are changing its shape and size. And if some iron article has been left to open, after some time it develops some reddish brown color flaky powder which is called rust. So these are the changes which we are observing. Look, when you cut a paper, then nothing new forms. Okay, you are just changing its shape and size. So this is a type of change. Now the second type of change, which I am discussing, the change in which your milk converted to curd, the change in which you saw iron developing rust, these are such change which cannot be reversed. They are something new formed. Okay. In this way, we have divided changes into two groups. They are physical change and chemical change. Now we will understand both of them one by one. Firstly, physical change. Those changes in which no new substance are formed are called physical change. In a physical change, the substance involved do not change their identity. Some common example, melting of ice. When ice will melt, it will form water. Ice was also a form of water and the liquid form is also water. So nothing new formed. Again, freezing of water to form your ice. Then boiling of water. Water will convert to water vapors. All are H2O by chemical name. Okay. Then condensation of steam. Again, the steam will come back to your liquid state. Then making a solution. When we dissolve two things together, that is also a physical change. Like you have added sugar to water, now that sugary water, the solution of sugar and water, will give you taste of both sugar and property of water. So mixing them together was a physical change. Glowing of an electric bulb, breaking of glass tumbler, these all are physical changes. Now let us understand what are chemical changes with example. Those changes in which new substance are formed, they are called chemical change. And in a chemical change, substance involved change in their identity. They converted to entirely new substance. The new substance usually cannot be returned to its original state. Okay, that's why I said your chemical changes are irreversible. Once done, can't be reversed. Now look at some example. Burning of magnesium wire. When magnesium wire will burn, it will form its compound called magnesium oxide. Now, second thing, burning of paper. When paper will burn, there a chemical reaction will occur and this change cannot be reversed. Then, rusting of iron, as I earlier told you, ripening of food, formation of curd from milk, cooking of food, all these are chemical changes. Now there is a practice session for all of you. You have to classify the following into physical change or chemical change. Let's see what are they. Cutting of tree. When a tree will be cut, nothing new will form. It will remain a tree. Okay. So physical change. Melting of butter in pan. Butter will melt to form liquid butter. Nothing new. Physical change. Rusting of almira. Chemical change. Boiling of water to form steam, we have discussed it. Again, a physical change. Passing of electric current through water and water breaking down into hydrogen and oxygen gas. The statement itself suggests that a chemical reaction is going here. Okay, this is the chemical effect of electric current. That's why this is chemical change. Now, next one is dissolving common salt in water. As I told you, mixing two things to prepare a solution is a physical change. This is going to be a physical change. Making fruit salad with raw fruits. You are just cutting, chopping the fruits. So, physical change. Burning of paper and wood. Chemical change. Because when paper or wood will burn, then their chemical reaction will occur and heat will evolve. So, these all changes we have discussed it. You can practice even more. That's all for today, students. Today we have understand many things. Now just one portion of this chapter remains, which we will cover in the upcoming session. Keep learning, keep asking. In case of any query, you can write in comments, you can ask in your class groups. So that's all for today. Have a great day ahead.